The shapes you see in road signs and logos are not completely drawn using computer softwares. If we fix a line in the software, then it is enough for us to draw only one side of the line. The other side will be automatically drawn using the reflection by the software itself. In this two-dimensional shape, as one part is the reflection of the other part, you can say this shape has reflective symmetry. The fixed line we use to create this reflective symmetry is called the line of symmetry. You might wonder whether it's really important to learn line of symmetry and reflective symmetry for this simple shape. This may not be useful for this simple shape, but using these concepts, many beautiful and complex designs and logos were designed. For example, let us consider this piece of cloth. The design in this cloth may look very complicated, but this design was created by using many lines of symmetry on a simple shape. Hey there, welcome to Fun Maths Academy. In today's video, let us check out how to identify lines of symmetry in 2D shapes and patterns and how to sketch lines of symmetry. But before we begin, let us recall what is line of symmetry. Line of symmetry is an imaginary line. When you fold a shape along this imaginary line, then the two parts on either side of the line will align with each other. You might already know about parallel lines and perpendicular lines. Parallel lines are equidistant, perpendicular lines will be at right angles to each other. You might even think why I'm talking about lines of symmetry, but you will understand why I did so when you start seeing some examples. Now, do you think there is a line of symmetry for this logo? Yes, when you fold along this vertical line, the parts align with each other. So this shape has one line of symmetry. Now, can you guess how many lines of symmetry this Google Drive logo will have? This logo has three lines of symmetry. Now, can you create a logo with one line of symmetry and another logo with two lines of symmetry? To learn more about lines of symmetry for different mathematical shapes, check out the link mentioned in the description box. In this example, we need to draw a reflection of this shape along the mirror line. Can you? Let me teach you a simple way to do that. First, mark all the corner points. There are in total three corners here. We need to draw a shape that reflects these three points on the other side of the mirror line. But where to mark all these corners? First, draw a line from this point which is perpendicular to the mirror line. Then measure the distance of this point from the mirror line and mark a point on the other side at the same distance. When you connect all these corners, you will get the mirror image. That's all. What will you do if the original shape is on the mirror line? We use the same method here. We need to make sure that the corners are at the same distance from the mirror line as they are from the other side. As the corners are at 0 units, you shall just consider the same point. Find the third point and connect the corners. One thing to note is that the original image had 3 corners and the new image with the reflection will also have 3 corners. Sometimes you will be given line of symmetry and square grids and you will be asked to complete the pattern using minimum number of squares. Just like how we mark corners there, here you will shade squares on the grid at the same distance from the mirror line. In the next video, we shall check out net of a 3D shape. Thank you. If you have liked this video, hit the like button. If you have found this video easy to understand and useful, share it with your family and friends. Do record your views in the comment section as this will encourage us to create more useful videos. Do not forget to subscribe to Fun Maths Academy channel to get constant updates on new videos we upload. Thank you.